I make sure that every day, you know, like my son, he is 2.5 now, and a year back he was 1.5. I want to share this for everyone to know. I take him to the cemetery every week. Just as soon as I cross Derry, he knows the road and he asks me, are we going to visit Mama? I say yes. Just as soon as I park the car, the Muslim graveyard is very modest. It is just a vast open space. There are no huge memorials and there is no fancy, you know, tombstones. So it's all very simple and very modest. And in that huge open space, he knows his mom's grave and he goes straight there. So these are the things that, you know, I keep on doing. Every day when we leave home, I make sure that, you know, he says, Mama, I love you. I want him to remember. You know, because 20 years down the line, he won't even remember what his mother looked like. So I need to make sure that he remembers that. I know I can't make up for that loss. You know, every day he may want to be held by his mother. He may want to feel her smell around him. I can't provide that. But what I can ensure is that, you know, I can ensure that that the memory lives in his mind. And we would be amazed. We think they're too small to understand. No, they're not. They understand and they remember. They remember. Now that he's grown up a little bit, he looks at her picture and he asks me, where's Mama? Almost every day. And I tell him every day, she's no longer with us, she's with God now. The thing is that we need to understand where we want to lead them. When he asks me that question, I can either distract him or hush him up, you know, not responding to it. But I choose to respond every time, telling him exactly where she is. Even if he doesn't ask me, I make sure that, you know, he looks at her picture, at her photograph, and he remembers her face. So, this is all that we can do.